All right, so one of the most important things as far as winter identification, if you are a homesteader, you just live in the Midwest and you like to, you have a wild area or you just want to work in the woods a little bit. So this right here, this is a plant called Virginia creeper. And of course, it's easier to identify because it has 5 leaflets when it's during the spring or when it's summer. It's a member of the grape family, Vitaceae. So Parthenocissus quinquefolia. So 5 leaflets. When I was young, people used to think it was poison oak. Actually, poison oak looks just almost exactly like poison ivy, just a little different. But you can see this really large, round leaf scar right there and this kind of brownish russet bud. And this one has gotten pretty big and leggy, so it's all over this tree. The other way you can tell when it's younger is it'll have this long curly cue. Basically, this is a tendril. So the tendril will attach the tree, and a lot of times it'll have suction pads on it. So there are other vines out here that have little rootlets, and that one, the one you want to really be cautious of if you're like me and you're allergic to it, this is poison ivy. So usually after it gets frosted a few times, it'll kind of turn yellowish, but especially here in Missouri, it'll come up from the bottom of the ground and be pretty tall, but generally it's smooth and the leaf scars are smaller. The leaf scars are basically, usually they kind of go around the leaf a little bit. This one isn't a super great example. Get this guy to go. But this is poison ivy. And unfortunately, I'm very allergic to poison ivy, so I have to be really careful. So I'm using gloves, I'm fully covered. But if it's an oil, so if you wash it off after you mess with it, it'll be okay. But it's a pretty tall plant, at least around here. As you go farther north, it doesn't get quite as tall usually. But on this property, it just kind of grows and it gets pretty big. One of the mnemonics people use is they say, "Hairy rope, don't be a dope." And it can be really bad during the winter time and late fall, because a lot of people got cut firewood and they don't know what they're doing, and they end up cutting lots of poison ivy. And if you burn poison ivy, the oil gets volatilized and then you get poison ivy all over your body, and that's not good. So here's another one. This is actually a big cluster that's coming at the base of this tree. Now the bad news is it's kind of a mixture of poison ivy and a Virginia creeper. Now you might think this was poison ivy. Actually, this is a Virginia creeper right here. When it gets really old, it gets these kind of big roots, but the roots are usually kind of light in color, whereas the poison ivy, when it gets really large, it'll get really hairy roots, like black and kind of hairy. So you can see here, see how these are not tendrils. These are roots coming out from the side. And you can see the leaf scar is not round, it's kind of U-shaped. So this is covering this tree. I kind of want to cut because it's a red cedar. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and cut these first with some clippers, let them dry for a few weeks, because once the oil is dry, it's much harder to get on your skin. So if you cut them at the base and then you cut the tree, you're a little safer. I still wouldn't burn it in my fireplace or in anywhere that you're going to breathe the smoke. I'll try to find a larger one for you to see. So here's a really big one. Well, it's not as big as it can get. It can get to about twice this size. This one right here, this is poison ivy. You can tell it's kind of got this black, icky looking hair. Sometimes it'll turn rusty, but it really looks hairy. Now over here, right next to it, this is Virginia creeper right here, but this is poison ivy. Now this is still, I think, attached at the base. Now this is still growing around this tree. It's attached to the base. And that means if you cut this, it's full of that Urushiol oil. So you would have to be really careful. Even though all the leaves are off of it, if you're allergic to urushiol, like most people are, really, really nasty. You can see these are the smaller ones growing up. So usually, there we go. That one's got a little bit more of a characteristic rusty color. So not quite so brown. You can see that U-shaped leaf scar. And then right next to it, we've got this guy. And then again, we can see that nice round leaf scar. And this has got, you can see right there, can you see the sticky pads right there? That's classic Virginia creeper. And Virginia creeper, most people are not allergic to it. Now, there are a few people that are actually allergic to Virginia creeper as well. Here's a living and active bud. Again, you can see that nice round. I see that nice round and I go, phew, that one's okay. Because I'm not allergic to Virginia creeper. And there are a lot of insects that actually feed on this plant. So I actually like to keep it around. And it competes with poison ivy. So I kill the poison ivy, at least when it's in my way. If it's out in the woods, I leave it alone. Because, of course, its berries are also valuable for birds. So if it's in the woods, you shouldn't go on a warpath. It's not an invasive species. But this is a place that's kind of on the edge of our property. We're trying to make use of it for other things, and unfortunately poison ivy is not a good thing to have in that place. Out in the woods, I'm not going to go ripping it out. But when I'm close to my house, I like having, and it's a little bit wild, I like having Virginia creeper, and that's right there. So this almost waterfall looking light roots right there versus the dark and hairy roots right here. So they're right next to each other. So hopefully that'll help you tell them apart. So you definitely don't want to cut something like this. Don't cut something like this and put it in your fireplace or on your bonfire. If you're allergic or anybody around you is allergic, you will be sorry. So be very, very careful with these. But that's all I have for you today. If you want to see more, give me a subscribe.